we have the HID projector set up here. Okay, we have the LED Bibeam projector on the car, and I'm just holding the halogen projectors. Okay, so we'll have a triple comparison kung ano yung itsura. Let's actually have the cameraman point at the curtain so we can actually see the difference. Okay? Hello and welcome to a new video. Welcome back. It's nice to be back. It's been a while since we had a video in this channel. And sorry, pasensya sa mga viewers natin. Ito lang ulit yung video na nagawa natin kasi we're quite busy with our other company called Fitment Engineering. Check it out at Fitment TV here at YouTube. But today we're going to talk about lights. We're at Chroma Lights TV. We're going to talk about a lot of things and a new product na ginagawa natin. Okay? So the title will actually say na it's actually Let's Modify GLS Montero ulit. So if you are familiar with our channel, we already made two videos for the GLS Standard and GLS Premium. Sa GLS Premium, pinakita namin ang problema ng mga GLS Premium models na naninilaw yung eyeline. Sa mga GLS naman, pinakita namin yung paano natin i-modify, papagandahin yung GLS Standard. Now, we have another GLS Standard here, but today we're actually retrofitting it with a different type of projector called the LED Osram Bibeam projector na we had ourselves customized sa isang factory. Kami ang pumili ng lens type, kami ang pumili ng LED chip, which is Osram, and then kami rin yung pumili ng mga flappers for the high beam. So you can say it's actually a Chroma Light certified projector. So maraming salamat dun sa aking supplier for actually providing us that kind of service. So ngayon, if you want to watch kung paano namin ginawa yung eyeline upgrade, nga pala, recap lang, ang ginagawa namin sa mga Montero is the famous eyeline replacement na fluorescent. 6,000 Kelvin yung ilaw niya, hindi siya bluish. With the sequential eyeline strip na naganon sa signal light. You know, the common, the usual na ina-upgrade natin. So sa mga hindi pa familiar doon, ang ginagawa po namin sa mga GLS is nilalagyan ng eyeline kasi yung GLS ay walang eyeline. Sa mga premium models naman, yung mga naninilaw, pinapalta namin siya ng eyeline. So if you wanna watch that video, so please click the link down below or click the box here kung saan ko man ilalagay. Yun po ang ating focus today, the projectors. Bakit? Ano bang naiba? Okay, to start off, i-explain ko sa inyo na ang stock projectors ng ating GLS Montero ay halogen. Boss, hindi ba pwedeng lagyan na lang yan ng HID bulb? Pag nilagyan nyo po ang halogen projector ng HID bulb, masusunog po yon. Hindi kaya ng wattage rating or ng UV rating ng projector yung init ng HID. Matutunaw po ito. Plastic lang to actually. Okay? So this is actually the stock projectors ng ating GLS Montero. Alright? Eh, paano naman sir yung mga popular plug-and-play LED bulb? Pwede ko mo bang ikabit yun sa puwet ng aking projector? Actually, pwede. And it won't really burn your projectors, pero yung LED optics natin o yung buga ng ilaw, hindi siya tugma dun sa halogen optics ng projector na ito. So that's why you would see, if you actually install a plug-and-play LED bulb sa mga gantong projector, either mahina yung buga ng ilaw or nakakasilaw ka ng kasalubong. Yun po yung reason kung bakit nagsimula tong retrofitting. Okay? Crash course, retrofitting is taking out the projectors and replacing it with a different type of projectors. Okay, kung wala ka naman projectors, magre-retrofit tayo ng projectors dun sa headlight mong walang projectors. Dun po nang galing yung pangalan na retrofit. 2017 kami nagsimula maggawa nito, and we started with HID projectors. So this is an HID projector. It has a bulb, okay? It has a projector, and it has a ballast, okay? So may ballast pa siya. Ngayon, 5 years later, it will actually be just a LED projector na. So ang LED projector, wala na siyang bulb, wala na siyang ballast, and yun po yung gagawin natin here. Or that's what we're going to do on this Montero. We actually changed the projectors already with LED Osram Bibeam projectors na kami ang nagpagawa. Yun po yung focus ng video na ito. Let's actually see the differences on this video kung gaano kalakas yung output change from a halogen projector, from an HID projector, and from the bagong LED Bibeam projector. Okay? So that being said, ginagawa ng boys yung eyeline sa likod ko. So while they're doing that, we can actually set up the wiring first and let's actually see the output changes ng Monterong to. So maraming salamat nga pala sa client for trusting Chroma Lights for their headlight solutions. And then of course, so sa mga interesado, please just message us on our Chroma Lights page sa Facebook and we can give you a proper inquiries. So we have a chatbot there that will actually give you a baseline prices ng kung anong meron kami. But I will be talking to you directly naman so we can actually discuss what type of package you want for your car. So ngayon, let's just wait for the boys to finish and let's actually fast forward a bit pagbuo na tong kotseng to and I'll see you there in a bit. Thank you. So we have a part in the setup. We have the HID projector setup here. Okay, we have the LED Bibeam projector on the car and I'm just holding the halogen projectors. Okay, so we'll have a triple comparison kung ano yung itsura. Let's actually have the cameraman point at the curtain so we can actually see the difference. Okay, I'm gonna be pointing with my fingers, so bear with me. So we have the halogen output here. I'm putting my hand on it so you can see. Yan yung halogen output. As you can see, that's very dim compared to the two beams below it. And of course, underneath all of that, we have the HID projector here. I'm putting my hand so you'll see. Okay? So there's significant improvement. Pansin nyo, maganda yung cutoff beam ng HID. Maganda yung output. And then we have the LED bi-beam ng Osram. And we have a very vivid and maganda yung hotspot niya. Something you need to know is maganda yung hotspot niya sa gitna. Okay? The hotspot here, very intense. You have a blue line, ibig sabihin, the line is being refracted properly. Tapos we have the HID projector, similar, okay? So I have to take note that all of this are without the headlights lens. So take that with a grain of salt. Yan yung output difference natin. We'll probably have a layout or a text para mas maintindihan nyo. Halogen on the top, HID on the bottom, and then the last one is the LED Osram Bibeam, okay? So yan yung comparison natin. Alright, sige. Alright, welcome back. Tapos na yung kotse. Maraming salamat for your patience on watching this video. As you can see, the car has its headlights again. Okay, nakakabit na. Check nga natin yung bago natin kinabit na eyeline. Once again, if you want to watch the video about the eyeline, may dalawa tayong video doon. Let's Modify Montero GLS and yung common issues ng GLS Premium. Nandun yung in-depth detail ng eyeline na yan, ng modification. Yan lang naman ang kinuha ng client. So from a GLS standard, mukha na siyang premium. Paka-signal light nga ako sa turn signal sa kanan. We have a flowing DRL eyeline working. Double check tayo. We're doing our final check dito naman sa kabila. Okay. Then hazard mo nga. It's a switchback LED. Pag bumalik siya, pag nag-hazard siya sabay, obviously. Pagbalik mo sa standard DRL, pakipatay. It will go back to white. So, yeah. And of course, yung ating beam output, papakita ko na lang as I speak. Magkakaroon tayo ng mga cinematic shot para makita nyo yung output. So double check natin yung beam output. And how was the comparison? Nakita nyo halogen, HID versus the new LED Osram Bibeam projector. So ngayon, this is the technology that we have. Malakas na ang LED projector. Sumahabol na ang LED sa scene. And I mind you, hindi siya LED bulb. It's an LED projector. Hindi siya bumbilya. Hindi siya kung ano man, projector po siya. Pinapasok po siya sa loob ng headlight nyo. Hindi po siya pwedeng bilhin. Ikakabit namin siya para sa inyo. Pero that's going to be it for now. Maraming salamat for watching. The client has to go. Tapos na ang retrofit natin sa short video just to introduce to you the new product and another Montero to work on. Apparently, sikat na Montero sa channel na to. Thank you for watching. It's been Cal from Chroma Lights TV. And you're watching Let's Modify. What's the next car? Probably we'll do this for a Fortuner as well. And other cars, let's see. But for now, that's going to be it. Thank you for watching. Subscribe to the channel, like and share the video, and hit the bell icon for a notification. And I'll see you on the next episode of Chroma Lights TV. Bye!